So hello everyone and very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of government schemes. In this session guys, we are going to discuss another very important scheme of the Ministry of Rural Development, and the name of the scheme is what? Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, agar aap pehli baar ye yahan pe video dekh rahe hain, so you can subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that aapko sari videos ki notification milti rahe, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. So let's begin with the session, and this is the scheme that we are going to discuss, Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. Okay, so let us first try to simplify the objective of the scheme. So what is the objective of the scheme? So guys, do I really have to tell you the objective? Because the name says it all, Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. So what is the meaning of gram? Gram means rural, while sadak means what? Road. So the basic objective of this scheme is that the government wants to provide all weather connectivity to the unconnected habitations in rural areas. All right, all weather connectivity they are providing to the unconnected rural habitations. Okay, and these rural areas should have population of 500 or more in the plain areas, while if it is a hilly area or it is a northeastern area or it is a tribal area, then this population criteria is how much? 250 or more. All right, so I hope guys the objective is clear. Through this scheme, government wants to provide all weather connectivity to the unconnected rural habitations with a population of 500 or more in plain areas, while with a population of 250 or more in the hilly, northeastern or tribal areas. So I hope guys the objective is clear, and as I told you, the ministry is what? The Ministry of Rural Development, which is currently headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar. But guys, before exam, you have to confirm the name of the minister. All right. And talking about the monitoring of the works, so who will do the monitoring? These things, guys, also you don't have to remember. I don't think that these things will be asked in an exam, but this is just for the basic understanding. All right. So monitoring of the work at the state government level, state government will deploy independent monitors for monitoring this work. They will be independent from any of the agency, from state government, from central government, from any of the central government agency or the state government agency. So they will be independent to monitor the works under this scheme. And also at the central level, there will be a body, independent national quality monitors. Okay, national quality monitors who will monitor the scheme at the central level. All right, and talking about the time limit for completion of work, so 9 months from the date of issue of order. Jab order issue ho jayega, usse 9 mahine ke andar andar us particular project ko complete karna hai, and this can be extended up to 12 month. This can be extended up to 12 month in exceptional cases, like for example bahut sari barish ho gayi in the monsoon cases. All right, then for hill roads it is the time limit is how much? 18 months, while for the tribal and backward districts it is 24 months. Okay, and now let's move on to the things that you have to remember. So I hope guys you already know the launch year. That was launched in the year 2000. It is a very famous scheme, you should already know the launch year. So it was launched in the year 2000. Jab ye 2000 mein launch hua tha, then that time it was a central sector scheme. All right, it was a central sector scheme, but later it was converted to centrally sponsored. All right, so now talking about the funding pattern. So what is the funding pattern? So it was initially a central sector scheme, but since 2015-16 it is being implemented as the centrally sponsored scheme, with the funding ratio between center and state it is 60:40, while for the northeastern and hilly state it's 90:10, while if it is a UT, 100% funding will be provided by the central government. All right, so this is the funding pattern. I hope this is clear. The launch year, it was launched in the year 2000. Okay, so these are guys some basic information about this scheme, Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. And now talking about Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana part 2. So its part 2 was launched in the year 2013. That's very important to remember. 2013 mein Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana second launch hua tha, with an estimated cost of 33,030 crores. Okay, what was the estimated cost? It was 33,030 crore of the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana 2. And what was its objective? So its objective was to cover the upgradation of existing selected rural areas jahan pe roads already ban chuki hai. Okay, selected rural roads based on their economic potential and their role in facilitating the growth of the rural economy. All right, so So that was the objective of Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana 2, and under it there was a target. And what was the target? To cover 50,000 km road length for the upgradation under this program. 50,000 km road length ko isme kya karna tha? Upgrade karna tha. Okay. So this Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana was for upgrading the rural roads. It was launched in the year 2013 with an overall target of upgradation of 50,000 km of rural roads and with an estimated cost of 33,030 crores. All right. And talking about PMGSY 3. So its third part was launched in the year 2019 with an overall objective of consolidation of 125,000 km through routes and major rural links connecting habitations to Grameen agricultural markets, higher secondary schools and hospitals. Basically, jitne bhi major link roads hain, unko kya karna tha? Consolidate karna tha aur ek proper network banana tha so that these roads can be connected to the Grameen agricultural markets, to the hospitals, to the schools and to the other important areas. Okay. And its estimated cost was 80,250 crores. And what are these through routes? You should know about these through routes. So these are the routes which collect traffic from several link roads. Bahut sari link roads jab ek jagah pe mil jati hain, then that is known as through routes. Okay. So for these through routes and major rural links jo ki connect karte hain hospitals ko ya agriculture markets ko, unko consolidate karne ke liye this Part 3 of Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana was launched in the year 2019 with an estimated cost of 80,250 crores. Okay. So guys, this was about the scheme. I hope the scheme is clear. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, the basic objective is to provide all weather connectivity to the unconnected rural habitations with population 500 or more in the plain areas, while 250 or more in the northeastern hilly or the tribal areas. Okay, it was launched in 2000 by the Ministry of Rural Development. Funding pattern iska initially central sector scheme tha, but now it is a centrally sponsored scheme with the basic funding pattern of 60-40, 90-10 and 100-0. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana Part 2 was launched in the year 2013 with an objective of upgradation of 50,000 km rural roads length with an estimated cost of 33,030 crore, while Part 3 was launched in the year 2019 for consolidation of 125,000 km roads with an estimated cost of 80,250 crores. Okay, so now guys, let's move on to the questions that can be asked in your exam. Consider the following statements regarding PMGSY 3. So these are the statements specifically about the third part of PMGSY and you have to identify the correct statement. So it was launched in the year 2018. So was that 2018 when it was launched? No, that was 2019, which means this statement is incorrect. And it has the objective of consolidation of 150,000 km through routes and major rural links connecting habitations. No, that was 125,000, which means this is also incorrect. And total estimated cost is ₹90,250. So that was not 90,250, that was 80,250, which means this is also incorrect, which means all the statement guys here are incorrect and we have to identify the correct statement. So therefore the correct answer should be what? Option D, none is correct. Okay. And moving ahead to the next question, what was the total estimated cost of PMGSY 2? PMGSY 2 ki total estimated cost puchi hai. So I hope you can easily answer this question now. Option B, 33,030 crore is the correct answer here. And question number 3 is, with respect to the funding pattern of PMGSY, you have to identify the correct statement. Correct statement identify karna hai with respect to the funding pattern. So it was initially a central sector scheme. Yes, this is absolutely correct. When it was launched in the year 2000, it was a central sector scheme till 2015-16. All right, which means this statement is absolutely correct. Since 2014-15, it is being implemented as centrally sponsored scheme. Yes, guys, it is currently implemented as a centrally sponsored scheme, but not since 2014-15. It's since 2015-16, which makes this statement incorrect. And for all UTs, the funding ratio between center and UTs is 100:0. This statement is absolutely correct and we have to identify correct statements once again. Therefore, option C. Option C, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. Okay. And guys, that's it for the scheme. I hope the scheme is clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.